كابتن وائل القباني نجم الكرة المصرية، نجم نادي الزمالك السابق، وهنتكلم معاه في نقاط أكيد كثيرة تخص أهمها يعني نادي الزمالك. لكن بالكلام عن الكرة المصرية والزمالك والأهلي ومشاركات الأندية المصرية، معانا عبر زوم من البرتغال مستر نيلو فينجادا، المدير الفني لاتحاد الكرة المصري السابق. مستر فينجادا، وهقوم بالترجمة سريعا. I'm very happy to have you on Skype. How are you, Mr. Vingada?
Everything is okay. Thank you so much. My pleasure also to talk for Egypt.
We are very happy having you and we miss you already.
Yeah, thank you so much. Me too. As you know, Egypt is my second country also in the family. We have so Egyptian blood, so yeah. I appreciate and I, of course, is a special affection that I have for that country, for that people, and amazing memories. All my time in Egypt was amazing.
We already treat you as an Egyptian, Mr. Vingada, but maybe the last memory in the Egyptian Federation, how can you describe it? Was it an amazing memory as well, or maybe it wasn't as amazing as the other memories?
Look, was different, but was a very good memory. So I've been so more than 1 year, so 1 year and a few days working in the Egyptian Football Association as technical director. Of course, the beginning was not easy because many issues and I need to study, but I believe that at least I sent the roots to make good things in the future, and I have been there in a good way, with respect of everybody, respecting too much all people that work around me. I have still, for sure, close friends inside the federation, and I made my best as professional. And of course, if you ask me, should be maybe important to continue the work, maybe, but also according what was our relation, special when the board changed, I think was more convenient in that time for both sides, so to give a chance to continue the work. And also I contact many times still the Egyptian Federation, and my disponibility to help and to serve the Egyptian football is always the same.
Okay, as you mentioned, it was important maybe to continue the work. And as you mentioned, you already put the roots for the future. Can you tell us about some of these roots, Mr. Vingada, or in other way, what we will benefit in the future from what you already have done in the past?
Look, I think the most important, of course, you know, when I was working in Zamalek or Egyptian national team or in a few countries where I worked as coach, so the, my work so can be seen by the results. So the results of the games can show what are you doing, if you are going well or not. So fortunately, most of times the results were okay, but sometimes also the results was not so good. But so this is the measure of the work of a coach, are the results. My work as technical director, of course, was not depending of the results, was to study, to reorganize the national teams. I believe now in the federation, there is a view that of course, not me alone, but working the people that was beside me as Mr. Wahba, so the Dr. Atem Sohor, so also all coaches that Mahmoud Gaber, all coaches so that were working with me. So we create like so one vision for all football until 2028. So today in the federation, we can look and we can see which is, of course, the way is not straight, but still we have a base to find the best players, to create great teams, and we are making so very good results, not only for the boys. So the team 2006 is a very good team. The team 2003 also is a very good team. the next Olympic team is a good generation, so that I hope can participate in 2024 the Olympic Games. The football for the women and the girls is growing up fantastic way, so it was a great surprise for me. So I can say that even not great visibility from outside, but inside, now the coaches, they know the rules, the principles that support all work for the national teams. So there is a vision that is, so is connected with good integration between different ages, different sectors. And I believe in the future, the benefit will come because in Egypt, we have fantastic players.
Okay, perfect. Before I translate what you already have said, Mr. Bingada, if I ask you about the best decision you have taken during your work as a technical director for the Egyptian Federation, what can you say? A decision you are proud of.
Look, for example, I believe one of decisions, of course, that was important was made when the Federation, and that decision was made by the Federation to replace Ossam Badri. And when was supposed to find a coach, the first name that always was in my head and the only name that I support was Mr. Queiroz. So I believe concerning, so with more visibility, was a good support that I gave to the Federation, to President Ahmed Begad, because of course the final decision and choice was made by the Federation, but I support that. But I believe that the most important, so generally that not the same visibility, not the same impact, but was to create like a philosophy and one vision for all youth football and for the also the work for the girls, because as I told you, in my activity, I was looking for the youth, for the girls, and for the boys at same level.
Yes, okay, let me translate because I already still have some other questions for you. I'm very happy having you. سألت مستر بنجادة في البداية طبعا بعد ما رحبت بيه هو رحب بيكم وقال لحضراتكم ان مصر بلد خاصة جدا وهو بيعتبرها بلده الثاني. قلت له احنا بنعتبرك عموما كمصري. قلت له يعني قال ان هو عنده ذكريات كتيرة قوي محببة في مصر. قلت له لكن هل, وده كان اول سؤال لي, هل ذكراك الأخيرة مع الكرة المصرية كانت بنفس روعتها اللي اتكلمت عن ذكرياتك مع الكرة المصرية؟ قال لي بالتأكيد هي كانت تجربة مختلفة. بسأله هنا على كونه كان مدير فني سابق للاتحاد المصري لكرة القدم. قال قعدنا تقريبا فترة أكتر من سنة, ما كانتش تجربة سهلة, لكننا وضعنا جذورا للمستقبل هتبنى نتائجها في المستقبل. أنا بحترم الجميع, ما زلت أمتلك أصدقاء مقربين, كنت بشتغل كمحترف في الاتحاد المصري لكرة القدم, يمكن كان من المهم أن أنا أكمل عملي عشان نشوف نتائج اللي احنا حطيناه. لكن لما اتغيرت الإدارة فكان طبيعي أن الإدارة الجديدة تختار أفرادا جدد من أجل العمل معها, فكان من الأفضل أن أرحل. قلت له انت بتتكلم على انك من المهم ان تبقى, وبتتكلم ان انت حطيت بالفعل جذور للمستقبل, ايه اهم اللي انت عملته؟ اعتقد لغايه النهارده الناس كلها بتسال هو ايه اللي عمله المدير الفني السابق للاتحاد المصري لكره القدم وهو بنجاده. فقال اهم حاجه عملتها انه طبعا هو بشكل عام الشغل مع الانديه دايما بيبان شغل المدرب من خلال النتائج, زي مع الزمالك حققت نتائج كويسه, مع التجارب التدريبيه الاخرى اللي عملتها كانت النتائج بتبين في اغلب المراحل ان الاداء كويس, بتقيم التجربه من خلال نتائج المدرب. لكن كمدير فني للاتحاد الجذور اللي بتكلم عليها هي ان احنا يعني حطينا رؤيه للعمل داخل الاتحاد المصري لكره القدم. كان في رؤيه اتحطت بالتعاون طبعا مع افراد في العمل زي الكابتن وهبه, زي الكابتن محمود جابر, شكلنا رؤيه تستمر معانا لحد 2028. عندنا منتخب بقى قوي زي منتخب 2006 ومنتخب 2003, ربما مش هتبان للناس اللي بره المنظومه لكن هتبان نتائجها لاحقا. بيقول ان احنا يعني عملنا كوننا فرق بشكل جيد, اهتمينا بالمنتخب الاولمبي 2024 اللي يتمنى ان هو يشارك في اولمبياد باريس. اتكلم كمان على تحسين مسيره منتخب السيدات, وان ربما لن يشعر بها الناس اللي موجوده في الخارج اللي هو احنا او حضراتكم يعني, لكن داخل الاتحاد بقى في منظومة اتعملت من خلال عمله بالتعاون مع الأفراد الآخرين، لكن بشكل عام في رؤية وفي أعمار مختلفة ساهمت في بناء هذه الرؤية. قلت له إيه القرار اللي أنت فخور بيه في خلال عملك كمدير فني في الاتحاد؟ قال لي إن هو وقت إقالة البدري أنا فخور بإن أنا دعمت جدا فكرة استقدام مستر كارلوس كيروش كمدير فني للمنتخب الوطني، ودي من خلال طبعا رؤية أحمد مجاهد الرئيس السابق للاتحاد، لكن أنا دعمت بقوة استخدام كيروش عشان يحط رؤية، إلى جانب إن أنا حطيت فلسفة عمل فني داخل الاتحاد المصري لكرة القدم وأشرفت على تنفيذ هذه الفلسفة. أوكي مستر بنجادا، أم باك. يو سيد You're proud of supporting the idea of having Mr. Kirosh as a head coach for the Egyptian national team. Now, after the experience already is done with the results we had, why you're proud of this, or how do you see the experience of Mr. Kirosh with the Egyptian national team?
Look, to make a balance after 6 months was more or less the work, the time that Mr. Kiroz worked in the Egyptian. So, and as you remember, he played some games to qualify the team for the next round. So, the four games remaining. So, of course, the results were positive and Egypt finished first. So, the winner of the group, so to qualify the playoff for the World Cup. After we played the Arab Cup, as you remember, this cup was played only with local players, but was important because we have the possibility to discover Abdel Bonham, for example, Ahmed Rifat, and some players that show that Egypt has a lot of talents, not only the stars that the people were thinking. Even we lost by, so the results, so we finished fourth, but really we lost by penalties. So penalties was our critical so point in these games in the Arab Cup and also in the final of the African Cup and also in the qualification for World Cup. As you remember, the expectations for the African Cup in AFCON in Cameroon, in beginning, even Egypt is a great name, is still the team and the national team with more wins in this competition, 7 times. But the expectations were not so positive. So I believe the people could not expect that we were to reach the final. I remember, especially when we lost the first game against Nigeria, the critics and so were very intense. So on Mr. Queiroz, on the team, not positive the way that those critics were made. But of course, football is made by results, and in football is not how we start, is how we finish. And even we finish losing the final by penalties, but no doubts that Egypt as country, the Egyptian people was proud about what the team did in this AFCON in Cameroon. So it was a great result, even as some friends tell me, the second is the best of the losers. So,
yeah.
but anyway, is a great result. And comparing what Egypt made in the last years, so reaching the final and losing by penalties, it was hard, but we made our best. In the qualification for the World Cup was the same. We beat 1-0, so Senegal in Cairo was an intense game. There was the same. So we lost 1-0 in penalties. As you remember, our best players to shooting penalty kicks. So Salah and Zizou, they missed the first two penalties. And after that, the pressure on the players so made them. And the way also the game, as you remember before the game, a lot of problems. So was unlucky. Even we have to recognize that Senegal is a fantastic team. No doubts that at the moment is the best team in Africa, and okay, we have to congratulate them, but of course you know, there is my vision is a little bit so the flavor not good, because even we reach the final, so we can say we are vice champions, even we lost by penalties, but the flavor is very, very bad,
yeah,
because we are not in this three because we didn't win and we are not qualified. And for me, to be honest, if we have to choose between to be champion and to be qualified, for me, I think for Egyptian football, should be more important to be qualified to the World Cup in Qatar because only three times Egypt was qualified.
Yeah,
and so it was very important and for this generation. But this is football. And I believe, anyway, I believe that Mr. Queiroz could bring for the federation and for the national team so a new vision, so a new kind of organization, and discover some good players that before didn't play in the national team. And I believe he prepared at least leaving, and now he's in Iran, as you know, but at least he prepared a good future for the coming times.
Okay.
And I hope now Mr. Rui Vitória can make and can bring the
course,
success that Egypt and deserve.
Yeah, I'll be talking with you about Mr. Rui Vitória, but talking about Mr. Carlos Queiroz, again, were you shocked about the not renewing the contract with Mr. Queiroz by the Egyptian Federation, or it was expected from you?
No. As you know, during the time when finished the game in Senegal that we lost, of course, as you know, Mr. Queiroz is not only a colleague, he's not a friend, he's more than that.
Yeah.
He's like a brother for me, so our families also are very close, he's as my brother. So I respect him too much as a person, as professional. Of course, his character is sometimes to work the way we have to understand him. And in the beginning, when he returned from Senegal, the game we lost by penalties for the qualification, the first talks was supposed that the things was going in a good direction to continue and to renew the contract. But of course, after that was so misunderstood, I believe, in the conversations and talks, and was not possible to reach the agreement. So as you know when sometimes when you are talking to renew the contract after the defeat also is not easy for both sides, and he was really disappointed, and for him was a great challenge to take Egypt to the special to the World Cup, and was not possible. So of course after during the time that was going, so for me was even I could not tell this outside, but it was clear that the so the final decision was what real happened.
Yeah,
and things even of course I believe he would like to continue, so he made an effort. Also the federation, I talked a few times with Hazem Imam, so as you remember, my captain in Zamalek in 2003-2004,
yeah,
and but was not possible. So, and now it's time to follow another way, another direction.
Yeah.
And the most important is Egypt, and now Mr. Queiroz is in Iran. So also, last week I have been with him here in Portugal. So, and the things now are going in another direction. So
he played again against Senegal.
Yes, and they play. I was telling him Senegal is following with him, and another draw. So I told him it was a good time to try to beat Senegal, but this game was in Austria, so during the camping, and finalized another draw. But it's okay. It was a good preparation for him because.
Yeah.
The first game they beat the Uruguay, so it was important and good start for him.
How do you expect his direction in the World Cup against USA, against England, against Wales in Qatar? How do you think he will qualify by Iran?
Look, you know, World Cup, the all groups are tough, but of course there is some groups that are more tough than this group. So looking for this group, of course, England is, we can say, is the favorite. So concerning the quality of the players, the league they are playing. So the intensity and the challenge, the speed, the power that they have, of course we can say England will be the candidate for to be number one.
Yeah.
Doesn't mean they will be win, but of course they have all favorite to be number one.
Yeah.
Looking for the other three teams, I believe we have three candidates for one place. So I be, regarding for all groups, if I could choose a group to be with a team as Iran or with a team as Egypt, I think these two opponents, United States and Wales, are good opponents. And Iran, I believe, have better chance now to qualify for the next round than before in 2018, where they were in the same group of Portugal and Spain and Morocco.
Yeah.
And as you remember, they lost 1-0 against Spain. They drew, they beat Morocco and they drew against Portugal. So I believe now Iran, because the base of the team is the same, they have now more players playing in Europe. They have more time working with this team. Even Mr. Queiroz reached the country just 3 weeks ago, but the base of the team is the same.
Perfect.
And I believe it's a good chance to qualify for the next round.
Okay.
No doubts about that.
Perfect. Okay. Some very quick questions with quick answers. Number one, have you got your last fees from the Egyptian Federation, you and Mr. Queiroz, or not?
Look, I talk for me myself.
Yeah.
For me, between me and Federation, everything
is okay.
Is okay. So, also, you know, and during the time that we were talking, everything was made between me. And during the time that I left after May, so I was continuing talking with Barakat, with Hazim Imam, and Mr. Walid. So, and also the president. Everything is solved in a good way. So no doubts about this. Also,
perfect.
I send a message to Mr. Ali that between me and Egypt, everything is solved and in a good way.
But
and
Mr.
respect
Queiroz,
all way.
Not
yes,
yet.
Mr. Queiroz, not yet, because as you know, there is this issue about the penalty, so $50,000. And what I know, so we're deducted $25,000. So the problem is not real solved, what I know.
Okay. Al Ahli, today they started the first campaign after with Mr. Marcel Koller by a win outside Egypt in Tunisia, 1-0. Zamalek won as well here in Egypt against Flambeau. A future as well won against this team, Kalon. So I'd like to ask you about Al Ahli. How do you see the start with a new head coach, Mr. Bingada, if you're still with me?
You know, look, of course, Arli was maybe the most difficult game because they played away against Tunisian team. Even, of course, the level and capacity of Arli is much better. But in these games, when you are playing away, and especially against Tunisian and Algerian teams, always is difficult. So they reach a good result. Of course, Zamalek only win 1-0, but they will play also second on home. Pyramids yesterday beat it 2-0, and also they play home again. So I believe the four teams of Egypt will be in the next round, so in the group stage. So I believe the normality will be done.
Perfect. One last question. What is your message for Mr. Rui Vitória, your compatriot, as the Egyptian national team head coach?
You know, before he traveled and before he decided to start the negotiations, of course, we talk sometimes by telephone because I have a good relation with him. I respect him too much. And I passed all correct. No, I don't want to say good or bad. I passed all correct information about Egyptian football, about federation, and about the challenge. And you know, the process to choose the new coach was tough, was hard. So in beginning was supposed Mr. Queiroz to continue. After came a few names. Now it's not important to talk about those names, but I believe the Mr. Rui Vitória is a good coach, is a very good person. So his mentality, his character, his feelings I believe can make easy adaptation in so in the way of Egyptian people, Egyptian as the country, the Egyptian mentality, and special the quality of the players. I believe he can improve and to bring the team for the level we deserve, because now the next challenge will be to qualify for the next African Cup in Ivory Coast that will be played now, not 2023, but now again in beginning of 2024. That is good, so good news for him, because more time to prepare the team, more time to know the players. And as you know, he's visiting the clubs, he's making good connection with all coaches. And I believe he has all conditions, with the support of the Federation and, of course, of the Minister of Youth and Sport, to make a good job.
Yeah, okay.
And he has capacity and character to make that also.
Yeah, perfect. You have already had a meeting with Mr. Gamal Muhammad Ali, the manager for the committee of the coaches. How was the meeting? If you can explain or give us a summary about it.
You know, look, it was a very interesting meeting, a nice talk. So, of course, I didn't know him personally. Even I know that he was coach. So we are talking about the Egyptian football, about Egyptian national teams. And it was very interesting. And even I left a few documents that still are in the Federation to be analyzed, to be discussed. Doesn't mean to be followed, but that means to be in a discussion.
Yeah.
And I told him that I'm ready anytime to give my best to support. Also, I transmit this information to Mr. Gamal Alam, the president, also to Barakat and to Hazim Imam, that the persons that work so more near of me, that even I'm out, but I feel as a little bit inside, because really part of me belongs to Egyptian football. And, you know, Egyptian is the only country that where I worked three times in different positions. So this means something. And to be honest, now when I came to Egypt, I came for the challenge. I came because it was Egypt. Of course, I'm professional, but I didn't come to get a lot of money or something like that, because I didn't get that. So I was very, very proud. Of course, if you ask me, I believe I could give, and I can give more, but I could give more. Anyway, I believe I transmit a new vision, new principles, new perspective. A new idea how to connect the different sectors, and I believe many of my message passed. And the most important, when I left, some of your colleagues tell me, and also I listened that Hazim Imam spoke about my job and my work and about the documents I made, and I'm very proud of this. And as I told you, I'm in Portugal. I'm not near, but also it's not so far to get and to reach Egypt. And I'm always ready, and to help Egypt is a happiness for me.
Okay. So we may see you again very soon in Egypt?
Inshallah.
Okay, perfect. Okay, thank you. Thanks a lot, Mr. Bengada. I was very happy having you at our show, El Match. Thank you.
Thank you. All the best, and good luck for Egyptian football, for the clubs, of course, all of them. And especially in the international competitions. Now the league will start. I hope, and this is a great challenge coming from the next season. It's time to recover, because it's not good for Egyptian football. The league start in October. So now in Portugal, we are already with 8 games.
Yeah.
In Europe, all leagues are, and Africa and most of the countries, between 8 and 10 games. Mm. So Egypt didn't start. So it's not... So it's something that Egyptian football, the federation, the clubs, and the professional league must solve, because this is important for the clubs and for the national team. And I wish the best, of course.
Thank you. We wish you all the best and health and happiness. Thanks a lot, Mr. Bengada. طبعا الترجمة الملخص المختصر المفيد قال انه ده لو انا عرفت اقرا خط، يعني انا ما بعرفش اقرا خط بكتبه بس ما بعرفش اقراه. قال مستر فينجادا لما سالته الاول على ايه اللي حققه كيروش عشان تبقى انت فخور بقرار استقدامه، قال التوازن اللي عرف يعمله خلال 6 شهور والانضباط مع الفرقه، انه تاهل للمرحله الاخيره من تصفيات كاس العالم، انه راح ببطوله كاس العرب، انه توصل لنهائي افريقيا. اي نعم الحسابات دايما بتكون ان اللي ما بيكسبش البطوله صاحب المركز الثاني بيتقال انه افضل الخاسرين، لكن انا بشوفها انه طلع لعيبه زي محمد عبد المنعم، زي احمد رفعت، زي لعيبه وفر فيهم الانضباط والتركيز والالتزام. ما كانش المنتخب متوقع انه يوصل لنهائي امم افريقيا رغم ان هو خد افريقيا 7 مرات قبل كده، بس وبعد الخساره من نيجيريا انتقد المنتخب بعنف، ما حدش كان متوقع انه يوصل للمرحله دي، وفي الاخر خسر بضربات الترجيح لما ضيعت من خلال اهم لاعبيك محمد صلاح واحمد سيد زيزو ضربات الترجيح، فده اثر على الحاله النفسيه لباقي اللاعبين فلم نتاهل للمونديال. فبيتكلم على انه طبعا احداث المباراه كمان اللي بتاعت السنغال دي اثرت في خسارتنا، لكن هو في الاخر هنأ منتخب السنغال. قال كمان ان هو افضل فريق في القاره منتخب السنغال، فتجربه كيروش هو يراها ناجحه رغم قصر وقتها. اي نعم كانت مره في نهايتها لكن ده اللي حصل. قلت له يعني هل صدمت بعدم التجديد لكارلوس كيروش؟ قال في البدايه كان الاتجاه هو التجديد ليه، لكن الطريقه اللي تم التعامل بيها في الاخر ودت الى عدم التجديد لكارلوس كيروش. هو في النهايه دلوقتي بيدرب منتخب ايران. قلت له ومنتخب السنغال برضه لعبه وديا؟ قال لي انا اول ما عرفت انه هيلاعب السنغال قلت له السنغال وراك وراك فاكسبها بقى، لكن اتعادل في النهايه وان كان كسب الماتش اللي قبله وديا منتخب اوروجواي. قال ان هو في يعني كيروش مش بس صديقي لكن هو جزء من عيلتي. قال ان مجموعته في كاس العالم مش مجموعه سهله، مجموعه صعبه مع انجلترا مع ويلز مع منتخب امريكا. انجلترا تبقى دائما مرشح الاول للتاهل عن المجموعه بالنظر لنتائج ايران في 18 مع البرتغال البرتغال واسبانيا والمغرب، فمع كمان 4 سنين سافر فيها لعيبه ايران الى اوروبا يتوقع ان يكون مرشح قوي للتاهل برفقه منتخب انجلترا عن هذه المجموعه. خدت مستحقاتك؟ انا عن نفسي خدتها، تواصلت بشكل ودي جدا مع كابتن بركات، حازم امام، وليد العطار، جمال علام مع حفظ الالقاب وخدت مستحقاتي. كيروش لا، لان القصه لسه شغاله بسبب موضوع ال 25,000 دولار في اعقاب العقوبه بتاعه مباراه المغرب والمؤتمر الصحفي. الاهلي بداية رائعة، انتصار خارج الأرض، مش سهل إنك تكسب على فريق تونسي أو جزائري خارج الأرض. الزمالك كسب على ملعبه لكنها اسمها خارج الديار، فانتصار مهم. بيراميدز وفيوتشر وفرحان للأندية المصرية ويتوقع إن هي كلها تروح إلى دور المجموعات في الأدوار المقبلة. إيه رسالتك لمستر روي فيتوريا مواطنك؟ فقال إن رسالتي ليه، هو كلمني قبل ما يجي مصر ياخد رأيي، ما قلتلوش حاجة حلوة أو حاجة وحشة، أنا قلت له الواقع بمعلومات كاملة عشان يبقى معاه الصورة. وهو اي نعم الاختيار خد وقت طويل في قصه كيروش والتفاوض وبعديها التفاوض مع فيتوريا، لكن فيتوريا مدرب جيد جدا، شخص جيد جدا، دماغه جيده جدا، هيعرف بسهوله يتاقلم مع العقليه المصريه، يعرف بسهوله يحسن نوعيه اللاعبين. عنده تحدي من حسن حظه ان تحدي بعيد شويه عشان يتاهل للمونديال، فالتحدي ده هو قادر على تحقيقه. وعلاقته بالأندية يراها جيدة من خلال زياراته للأندية، وده بيخليه متفائل بنجاح فيتوريا مع منتخبنا الوطني. أخيرا سألته على اجتماع تم ما بينه وما بين مدير إدارة المدربين الدكتور جمال محمد علي، قال لي اتكلمنا، اتكلمنا عن الكرة المصرية، اتكلمنا عن المنتخبات. قلت له ان انا سايب وثائق بالفعل للمنتخبات في اتحاد الكرة، ممكن يروح يدرسها يحللها لان هي هتكون مفيدة في تجربته في الفترة الحالية. قلت له ان انا جاهز في اي وقت للخدمة حتى وانا في البرتغال مش بفلوس، انا تجربتي اللي فاتت في مصر ما كانتش الغرض منها ابدا الفلوس، مصر بلد عشت فيها 3 مرات مع مناصب مختلفه، فانا جاهز للخدمه طول الوقت وممكن اكون موجود في مصر اذا اردتم في اي وقت مش عشان الفلوس. دي كانت ترجمتنا للحوار اللي اجريناه مع مستر نيلو فينجادا. وبعد الفاصل الكابتن وائل الاباني نجم الكره المصريه والزمالك هو ضيفنا عن الامور دي وعن اوروبا كمان هنتكلم مع